I'm trying to imagine a time when, like deer, we wandered into a valley and it was good. The water ran clear, so we built a fire for the night and stayed a while. We put a seed in the ground. We put our bones in the ground before the water ran clear. I'm trying to imagine a time when it was kind and our seeds grew from joyful bones. We could breathe the air. We could literally breathe the air. The soul was good, so we built a body out of songs and stayed a while. The water ran clear. We could drink, bow down to it as deer. Was there ever a time when it was good? Because the sky's instinct is beauty. Because walking the trail of the deer fills us with sky. Oh, good must be imminent. The seed is waiting in the dark. The seed is waiting for water or maybe fire to open. If ever that time was or is to be, I reckon it'd be there. In the passage of clear water running through the earth.
I've just been in Virginia for 3 years, but I live in the country, and so I hear people talk about their kin, talk about their kinfolk, and they're talking about their aunties and their uncles and cousins, and I just love the word. You know, kin is your family. Folk refers to the people, and so I think in combining those two and looking at them separately, they say that your family is the people, and so how can we expand that definition to envelop all the people, where you take everyone to be your cousin and your auntie? And how can you take that a step further, where you could take the deer to be your cousin and the water to be your mother and the soil to be your father? Who sustains us? Who is our family? The whole world is our family. How can we embody that and open our heart to that greater conception of family? Because our lives really do depend on it. I've been thinking a lot about deer because of living out on the land and deer being everywhere. Indigenous people would, like the big game animals, they would be their kin because they would feed them, they'd clothe them and house them. And so playing around with that idea of the animals that we live with are our kin. So I use them, and I've been exploring that imagery. They are all around us, yet they're wild. And there's something in us that's wild too, and that an algorithm cannot crack, and that cannot be tamed down or made into a commodity or bought or sold. And that freedom and wildness in the deer reminds us that we are part of nature. We're not separate from nature. Every day, we survive in the best way we can, just like the animals survive. I thought it was really important to put a land acknowledgement in the mural because of respect to the land that I'm painting on. Beneath the concrete is the earth and the soil, and beneath the soil are the bones of all the ancestors who have lived here. And so thinking about the land, thinking about the Monacans, it made me realize how they're struggling for a piece of land that's 35 miles south of here that was their ancient capital from 5,000 years ago. And they're trying to protect it from a water pumping station there. So I thought it was a nice way that we could talk about how do we take the idea of kinfolk a step further and embrace the original people here as kin and be able to explore and express kinfolk, not just appreciate it as an image or as a word, but have the mural be a gesture of kinship.